Hope all of you are doing well. Welcome to your biology class. Last time we started chapter biotechnology and one topic of this chapter is left. So today I will try in this video to cover this topic. Before starting a new topic, just take a quick review about the last video. In the last video, I explained about biotechnology. And what is biotechnology? Yes, biotechnology involves using living organism to carry out processes to make substances that we want. And we also studied about some examples like bacteria, which help to make cheese and yogurt. And we also discussed about that yeast, which is help in the making of bread and alcohol. And we also discuss about the reason that why we use microorganism in biotechnology. And what are these reasons? I know all of you remember. Yes, because they are very small, they are very easy to grow, their reproduction time is very small. Like bacteria only grow in just 20 minutes. And one important thing that bacteria possess a circular DNA, which is called, yes, plasmid. P-L-A-S-M-I-D, plasmid, remember? Yes, which can easily transfer. And we also discussed about how we make biofuel and bread while using yeast. And we also discussed about use of enzymes in biological washing powder and in food industry, like for example pectinase and lactase. And we also discussed about the production of antibiotic penicillin. Penicillin is an antibiotic which helps to cure bacterial infection. And what is the mode of action of penicillin antibiotic? It's actually disrupt the formation of bacterial cell wall. You know, every antibiotic has different mode of action. So the mode of action of actually that's penicillin antibiotic is it disrupt the formation of bacterial cell wall. And you already studied about in chapter drugs about this mode of action of bacteria. So today we are going to start the last topic of this chapter, biotechnology, which is called genetic engineering. So before defining that what is actually genetic engineering, the word genetic is actually derived from a word gene. And what is gene? You already studied in inheritance, remember? Yes. Gene is a length of DNA that codes for a particular protein. And in the last video, I mentioned about that in 1970s, the new branch of biotechnology emerges in which the scientists first time find out that how they take a gene of one organism and put into different one to produce the product of their choice or to produce the product which is useful for mankind. This branch of biotechnology is called genetic engineering. You know, students, genetic engineering was first carried out in the 1970s. Yes. And since then, many different uses have been found for this process. Now, all of you are ready because I'm going to define genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is defined as take a gene of an organism and put into another organism. In other words, you can say changing the genetic material of one organism by removing, changing, or inserting individual genes. The diagram below showed how the process of genetic engineering is carried out. In the later slides, I will explain to you how this process happened in detail. Don't worry. We will discuss the process of genetic engineering with respect to two examples. Number one, in the production of human insulin. And number two, genetically modified crops. And it is also called GM crops. GM capital. you know, students, before genetic engineering, how insulin was produced. Insulin was taken from cow and pigs. And I know all of you remember that what is the function of insulin. Insulin is an hormone which is found in our body, and it helps to reduce our blood sugar level. Because too much blood sugar level is there, or high blood sugar level is there, so it can cause a disease condition which is called what? Diabetes. Yes. And you know, insulin is produced by liver, and the liver beta cells, and which is also called Isles of Langerhans, they are actually responsible for the production of insulin. And you remember your level 8 chapter, pathogen and immunity, in which we discussed autoimmune disease, in which actually we discussed about the example of insulin diabetes type 1. Actually, in those people, what happened? Their immune cell, that is white blood cell, destroy the liver beta cells. So there's no insulin production happen in their body, and these people have diabetes type 1. And this type of diabetes is usually common in adults. Okay, adults or young people. This question came into the mind of the scientist that how genetic engineering is carried out, because the principle of this technique sound very straightforward, that take gene of one organism and put it to another. But in practice or in practical, it is extremely very difficult, because this genetic material, it's microscopic in size, and a technician cannot use a pair of scissors to cut out a gene. And secondly, the host organism, that is the one that will receive the valuable gene, that would not normally take in DNA from another organism. And last one is product formation, that the host organism may be not showing valuable characteristics. For example, it may not make a particular protein, even it has the DNA that codes for the protein. So scientists encounter all these problems. So don't be sad, as because the technological advances has overcome this problem. And key to success has been the discovery of enzyme vectors and culture techniques. So some requirements are needed to carry out the process of genetic engineering, out of which number one is enzyme. And the enzyme that is need to cut actually DNA from one chromosome and paste it into another, acting like a scissor and glue. And the example of these enzymes are restriction enzymes and ligase enzyme. Genetic engineering is vectors that can carry the gene from one organism to another. And the last requirement of genetic engineering is cultural technique. You remember this setup, the diagram on the right side? Yes, in which we grow the penicillium fungus in order to get penicillin drug. Yes, so this vector is actually transferred into a host organism cell, and whatever the information is actually contained in the DNA of organism, so it produces the product. So cultural technique is actually allow the large quantity of valuable product or the product of our choice to be produced, and we collected it. Even the host organism would not normally produce it, but this host organism will produce product for us. Following are the basic steps of genetic engineering, which are listed below: isolation, cutting, insertion, transformation, also called recombination, and number 5, expression. The given diagram on the right is actually showing how genetic engineering is carried out. The same diagram I will explain in the next slide. Let's discuss about the genetic engineering steps in detail in the formation of human insulin. So the first step of genetic engineering is isolation. So this is human cell chromosome, which is isolated, and the gene which is responsible for insulin production is recognized. Similarly, this is bacterium and chromosome plasmid is isolated. In the second step, with the help of enzyme restriction, the human gene which is responsible for insulin production is cut. Similarly, the bacterial plasmid is cut with the help of same restriction enzyme. What is the reason why we are using same restriction enzyme? Because when we use restriction enzyme, it cut the DNA molecule at a particular point and it leaves the short lengths of unpaired bases. So this is called sticky ends. So in the next step, we use ligase enzyme in order to join human insulin gene with the bacterial plasmid. So the ring of DNA in the plasmid is cut, and using the same restriction enzyme that were used for cutting the human DNA. The reason for this is that these enzymes will leave sticky ends that are complementary to the ones on human DNA. So now we have a plasmid that contains the human insulin gene. And this plasmid is called recombinant plasmid. Why? Because it contains a combination of bacterial and human DNA. So the next step is expression. The genetically modified plasmid are added to a culture of bacteria, and some of the bacteria take up the plasmid into their cell, and these bacteria are put into a fermenters. What is fermenter? You remember the production of penicillin production? Yes, the same fermenter we used. And in this one, bacteria reproduce asexually to form large population. And they follow the same instruction on the human DNA to make insulin. And at the end, we can extract it, the insulin from the fermenter, and purified it. So these are all the steps involved in the production of insulin using genetic engineering steps. The given slide is actually the quick review of all the steps of genetic engineering again, so that you will not forget. So let's discuss one by one. Number one, restriction enzyme is used to cut out insulin gene for making insulin from human DNA. Same restriction enzyme, remember that, is used to cut open plasmid DNA of bacteria. Number 3 point, insulin gene is inserted into plasmid DNA of bacteria and is joined together using ligase enzyme. Don't forget ligase enzyme. Number 4, insulin gene is now recombinant or transformed and inserted into a bacterial cell, which act as a vector. Last, transgenic bacteria is complete, contain genes from different species, like from human to bacteria, and is grown in a fermenter to reproduce and duplicate. Now I think all of you by heart the steps of genetic engineering. So we use two enzymes in this process. Number one, to cut the DNA, which is called restriction enzyme. And number two, we used enzyme ligase in order to seal the DNA or join the DNA, or which act as a glue. And the one important thing that we use fermenter to make more copies of bacteria in order to get more insulin. So now we are going to discuss about the second example of biotechnology, that is genetically modified crops. And you know, students, apart from insulin production or using animals genetic engineering, plants are also genetically modified to be resistant to herbicide or insect pest. The example of this is genetically modified soya plants. So soya plants genetically modified, so they are not harmed when herbicide called glyphosate is sprayed on them. This means that if a farmer can spray a field with herbicide glyphosate, so these plant cannot have any effect. and only weeds are killed. You know, students, apart from soya plant, rice also genetically modified to produce more vitamin A than normal rice, because you know, lack of vitamin A is a big problem in children in some part of the world, mainly in those parts where their diet is mainly consist of white rice. And you know, severe vitamin A deficiency can cause blindness and is thought to kill more than 1 million people each year. So growing and eating golden rice rather than ordinary rice, it's a big help in solving this problem. But still, there are some concern about the use of genetically modified crop, and we have to consider them carefully. Like for example, some people have argued that golden rice is not the way to solve problem by caused by vitamin A deficiency, because we have to find out the real cause of problem and solve it. And what is that? People do not have enough money or enough food in some part of the world. So students, as before, I gave you the example of genetically modified soya plants. So they are resistant to herbicides. So let's discuss about genetically modified cotton plants. What is BT cotton? This is actually genetically modified variety of cotton that produces an insecticide. And you are very well aware about insecticide. What are insecticide? Chemicals which kill insect pest. So cotton plant have been genetically modified, so they contain a substance called BT, which is toxin to insect, especially insect cotton boll weevil are killed if they eat the cotton plant. This reduces the use of pesticides. And what is the full form of BT? See the diagram on your right. It's called Bacillus thuringiensis. What is called? Bacillus thuringiensis. Got it? I got it. You got? So what are the advantages of BT cotton? See this diagram on your right. The advantages are listed. It increases yield superiority, more profit, lesser need of pesticide, better quality of cotton, and suitability for early sowing. So these are all the advantages of BT cotton. We are going to discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of genetic engineering. So let's discuss first advantages of genetic engineering. Number one, it reduces herbicide spray. You know, growing genetically modified crops that are resistant to herbicide reduces the number of times that farmer need to spray herbicides on their crops, and this also reduce the number of occasions on which the herbicide might cause harm to other plants which are growing nearby. Second advantage is it increase crop yield. Growing herbicide resistant crops can also increase crop yield, because the spray that is used is very effective at killing everything other than the crop plant. And third advantage, that it reduces labor cost, so it's mean cheaper food. So let's discuss about the disadvantage of genetic engineering. Insects become resistant to BT toxin. One issue that is emerging is that some insect pests are evolving to become resistant to BT toxin, and this is also a new problem. So as resistant to ordinary pesticides has evolved on many occasions. So how to overcome this problem? A possible way of avoiding this problem is to plant only certain area with BT containing crop and grow non-BT crops nearby. So when insect pest will be able to feed on the non-BT crops, so they will not develop resistant to BT crop. So these are all advantages and disadvantages of genetic engineering. I hope all of you understand it very well. So at the end of the lecture, you are able to understand about genetic engineering. We discussed about example of genetic engineering as well, like for example insulin production and genetically modified crops. And we also discussed some ways in which genetic engineering is useful to us, along with arguments against the use of genetically modified crops. And at the end of the lecture, we also discussed about the advantages and disadvantages of genetic engineering. I hope you understand it well. If you have any doubt, just go through your textbook lesson. So this is all about a biotechnology chapter. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye.